Welcome back to the Mountain Morning Show. It is time for Comic-Con, and arguably one of the coolest things that you're going to see there is Battlefield Earth. And I'm very happy to have Emily Goodwin here. She's the Vice President of Public Affairs for Galaxy Press. Hello.
Hello, Joe. Thank you for having me back.
I'm thrilled to have you. I am excited about the book. You guys have you re-released it in hardcover originally, and then, of course, also with an audio.
Yes.
And wild amount of excitement about this.
Yes, absolutely. We're very excited. So we originally released the book again in 2016 and the audiobook, which I know you've had a chance to listen to.
And I love it. It's amazing because it's not a typical audiobook with just somebody narrating. It is way different. It's a full production.
Yes, we had 67 actors on for that. We used 150,000 sound effects, which is a massive production.
Wow, yeah. That is impressive. Yeah. Now, of course, the big deal is that with Comic-Con, there's so much interest in science fiction that you guys, I mean, where could you possibly be this weekend other than here?
This is the perfect place to be for us this weekend. We're very excited. It's our fifth time coming here to Comic-Con. We have a special guest that'll be here with us at Comic-Con.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, that's always exciting.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, it's Turl. You kind of frightened me there a little bit, my friend. Good grief. Very terrifying. This is the guy who really wants to dominate all of us.
Yes, this is Turl.
I'm a little concerned about that, that we have him here in studio. But, you know, things that the when you consider the state of current affairs, it shouldn't surprise us easier, I don't suppose. Wow.
He traveled far for Salt Lake City Comic Con.
Indeed he did. I am very happy to have you here, Turl. Thank you for joining us, but maybe next time a little warning. I'm just saying. I know you're the bad guy, and that's your normal mode of operation, but it would have been a little kinder to your interviewer. I'm just saying.
Well, so, he will be with us at Comic-Con. People can come and see him at the booth. He'll be available for alien selfies.
I think he has an ulterior motive. Let's just be honest. I don't know that he really wants to make friends with all of us, does he? Yeah, that's what I thought.
No.
Not so much.
He's not the friendliest character in the book.
He's a little hairier than the rest of us.
Yes.
I'm just saying. We may have maybe figured out now why we've had so many Sasquatch sightings as of late. Because we have, ironically, here in Utah. This is fairly typical. I think they might have been mistaking you. Are you okay with that? I mean, Sasquatch is just as mean, I think. This says bring him on.
Bring it on.
Oh, boy. And all of the accoutrement of the character in the book, we see everything here, including even the fingers.
Here he is.
Wow.
He even has the 11 fingers that the Cyclos have in the book.
Wow. What I really want to know is, I want to talk fashion for a moment. Can I take Kelly's place for a moment and talk fashion?
Sure.
The boots are impressive. I don't know where aliens get boots like that. I'm supposing that they have a manufacturing ability that we're not familiar with?
Well, Planet Cyclo has its own fashion.
Yeah, these look like Gene Simmons boots. Perhaps he took them from him. Maybe.
Well,
this is great. So you guys have a booth at Comic-Con.
So
now, Comic-Con is huge. So tell us where, because I'm kind of curious about where you're at.
Yeah, so it's in the Salt Palace Convention Center.
Right.
We are at booth 1504.
1504,
Galaxy Press. We'll have Battlefield Earth available. Anyone who gets the book, you actually can get the T-shirt with the cover art.
Is that right?
Turl. Yes.
Ah.
And get a picture with Turl at the booth.
That picture is going to be for many young people a little scary. Let's take a look. We've got a picture of you. Well, we've got a video of you getting a photo, I think. So let's take a look at that. Yeah, there we are. So lots of young people pretty excited about being a thrill. I think you're looking to maybe eat her. Which is a little bit terrifying. But nonetheless, we know there are a lot of young people who are going to be very excited. But that's maybe the thing that we should talk about. This is generational because it is a re-release. The original release was back in
1982.
Wow.
It is timeless. It is just as popular today as it was when it was originally released. We have sold 4 million copies of the book. and it continues to sell, continues to be popular, because it's not only a science, you know, it's a science fiction novel, but it has everything in it. It has romance, it has war, it has education. Education is a big part of this book. I mean, the human drama. Yeah, the human drama. The humans come together to overtake this dominant race that has taken over on the planet.
I think he's eyeing me. I'm a little concerned. The other part that I'm excited about, too, is the expanded content. So an author interview.
Yes.
This was one that was done years and years ago with L. Ron Hubbard.
And there are discussion guides in the back of this particular book, which is in addition to this mass market copy.
That's awesome
that
for a teacher.
It is.
For instance, I can imagine. I mean, this would be a big assignment to give young people, but
yes.
It might be fun to, and I would like this. I always enjoyed when my teacher read. A little bit of the teacher reading, a little bit of you reading, mm-hmm. and some discussion with this guide that's in it. That could be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Wow.
Excellent new addition.
It is indeed. Well, I want to take a quick break because I want to make sure that our co-host Kelly gets out here and gets a moment with you. If you eat her, it's okay. It'll be fine. she's a tasty morsel. So we've got that. Maybe that will happen here on the Mountain Morning Show. You'll want to stay tuned as we continue our conversation with the folks from Galaxy Press and Battlefield Earth right after this. Welcome back to the Mountain Morning Show. You know Comic-Con is happening. Why? Because we have one of the characters that many people are going to want to visit with at this year's Comic-Con, Battlefield Earth. Turl is here. And Kelly seems to be warming right up to him.
Well,
do you like the
I'm
hairy guys?
I'm scared of the fingernails. I mean, seriously, there are 6 fingers on this hand.
You seem cozy. That you realize this is not a Nuzzles & Co. interview. He's not up for adoption.
Oh, I take
I'm just
home.
Saying. she likes some hairy
the
guys.
The 6 fingers are part of the story. It's a key part of the story, actually.
Tell me about
with
it.
The mathematics of this race, they use in 11 instead of 10, and so they have 11 fingers. It's a key
counting.
Part. That's why he has 6
always,
fingers on that hand.
Is it always the right hand?
Yes.
It is?
Yeah.
Are you right-handed? Yeah?
That's why his ray gun's on his right side, too.
True,
yeah.
True.
So,
tell me about this.
So this is part of his breathe mask. See here, he does not breathe in our atmosphere here, so
oh,
he
rough.
Has his own tank here.
So if we need to defeat him, we just need to pull the hose.
That'll work.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, he might
That's
die.
The way. That's the way to defeat Turl.
This costume is impressive, I got to tell you. We admit for a moment that as we quit suspending our disbelief for just a second, the Hollywood level, you guys are from Hollywood, it makes
yes.
sense. Talk about this. This is impressive.
So this costume was made by Tom Spina Design. It's based off the Frank Frazetta character, which is on the cover of the book here. And it was made in New York by Tom Spina. Tom Spina is actually here at Salt Lake City. He'll be on
oh,
some
is that
panels.
Right?
Yes.
Oh,
he'll
that's
be,
awesome.
Yeah, he's here this weekend.
Wow.
So I'm sure he would love to answer questions about his process. He does a lot for Star Wars and a lot of amazing costuming. And it was a long project, and he brought this Frazetta character to life. And
that's impressive. The helmet alone is
yes.
is just outrageous, or the head dress, I should say.
The whole head.
His head. It's going to be fun also, not just to talk about Battlefield Earth, but Galaxy Press also be talking a little bit about writers and illustrators of the future.
Yes.
And the fact that, you know, really this, for anyone can be, their future could be writing something like this.
That's
and
right.
Might be sitting here with us next time.
Yeah, absolutely. We would love, there's a lot of writers in Utah.
Yeah.
We get a lot. We run the International Writing Contest, Writers of the Future, and also Illustrators of the Future. And we encourage people to enter the contest. It's free to enter. We get a lot of entries from Utah. Something in the water
and
here.
And a lot of winners
a lot
here
of
as well.
Winners.
Well, we're all winners today with Turl. Hopefully he's going to let us live to see you on the next Mountain Morning Show. Until then, make sure you get down to Comic-Con. Check out the folks from Galaxy Press. We will see you tomorrow from 7 to 11.